performance of Little Shop of Horrors. Please note that the use of flash photography is not permitted. And also remind yourself to turn off your mobile phones. A, because it's rude, and B, so you're not eaten by the plants. Enjoy the show.
Yourselves.
Better ourselves. Mister, when you're from
Today.
Yeah, now isn't that bizarre?
At least, what kind of weird old plant you got, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of fly trap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Orchard 2.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window,
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't just suddenly.
Well, excuse me, I can help noticing a strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an orchard, Tim.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, do you remember that total eclipse of the sun a few weeks back? I was walking past the whole field cloud district that day.
Shoot,
I drove past this place with this old Chinese guy.
Shoot,
he sometimes sells me weird and exciting kind of things. He knows the strange plants when I have them. He didn't have anything unusual there that day.
Shoot,
I was about to, walk on by.
of mice can see. My God, I'll never believe it. My children, I'm taking us all to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Mushy
Pot. You have a day. You're not saying no good, Nick. I'm telling you, Audrey, you don't need a date with him. You need major medical.
He's a professional.
The guy in the professional drives a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket.
Oh, he's a rebel, Mr. Mushy. And besides, he's the only
fellow
I got. Enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night,
Audrey. Poor girl.
Are we still going for dinner tonight?
You're not going anywhere, Cromwell. You're staying right here, taking care of this sick flat. How come it's always fainting all the time?
I told you, it just looks like this. The Orgy 2 is not a healthy girl.
Stuck in between us, and even the Orgy 1.
If only I knew what breed it was. Genus, but it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Cromwell, is your best figure it out. And fast, just look what this exotic beauty did for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse that blood to health.
I will.
I'm counting on you.
I know.
So fix. Good night.
Good night. So we don't know what else to do for you. Mr. Marshall and Audrey, they just met you. But I've been going through this with you for weeks. Grow and grow. Spurn and flock. Are you sick, little plant? Or are you just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine.
This has been made
open 6 days a week!
Girls,
admiration for stepping up and booming, cause consumers are flocking as business has been booming. We need refrigeration and our new improved display, so we'll close a renovation today.
Yes, indeed, to this shopping ground now, the top 5 rooms. Yes, your interiors on display exclusively.
Reporter decoration, attention and smiling. Tonight we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll take a shit shot someplace, our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but all these band-aids make it kind of hard.
You'll be getting hurt so much.
No, it seems like every time I pick up these booty shoes, I slip.
Professor renovation, for swapping down and booming. Since this has been climbing, as all your tools been booming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say, you know, a bunch of peonies.
And now he doesn't
think to
please.
Geraniums and enemies.
We're getting
nuts and boy,
we've
got to talk
about every painting for the COD.
I forgot!
You forgot? The Sheeves are our most important funeral account. But an enormous family like them, they're dropping off like flies. I'm telling you, Crowborn, if you lose that business over this, you are finished!
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushik's too hard on you.
I don't mind. Besides, I owe him everything. He was the one that took me out of the Skid Row home for boys when I was just a little tyke. Gave me a nice place to sleep, under the counter. Nice food to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep, toilets to clean, and every other Sunday off. Job, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you do.
Well, I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen in a public place, like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight? Not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee.
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
Well, that doesn't matter. You have a lot of experience.
Some experience? I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
I have a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. Besides, it's dangerous.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 3030 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dime.
Hey, no problem. See you, Joe.
It's right over there, but if you'd like the 1,000 of us walking down to see the RT2, you better come back tomorrow, man, because this shop is closed today.
Not any of our posters, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date?
You ain't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye
and several other medical problems.
Well, as a matter of fact,
that's him! That's
him! You want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost by Taylor's brains? Well, I think Audra needs is one of your kinds.
My kind is a very nice kind. Ladies, I'm not a monster.
And what the hell would you call it?
I'd call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. And I'm going to explain. Younger, just bad, my mama knows what I'm thinking. Like shooting puppies.
I'm not afraid to
the paper said I touched I really am. And when you reach the age of 83, I'll let you come through with me.
You swear that? Brother son! Plus Nick and son,
that's that. Officially I'm your friend.
Consider the matter closed and done. Now to the world, let's stick. I'm senior and junior spick. Audrey, come on, bring it over.
The drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore. Sturdy, heavy, and dull. This is going to be a challenge. This is going to be a pleasure. I bought some gas for this one.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't going to give me any.
Oh, the gas isn't for you, Seymour. It's for me. You see, I found a little giggle gas before we begin. Increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm gonna use my special gas mask for this one. Just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Now, do it now, the flicker
enough of this, Eliza. Hey, Seymour, guess what?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mouth is stuck, I can't get it off. Give me a hand, Brent.
Well?
Well? He says, well. Hey, Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like this. I'd be happy, don't. It's just the gas.
Thank you.
down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I've never been so relieved as the when they told me he'd vanished. Not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salts and ace bandages.
Then, what's the matter?
Show me your face. It's
wouldn't you excuse me and Seymour for a little while? Perhaps you'll like to visit your dentist friend?
Oh, dear, that wasn't very funny. You know he's disappeared.
Oh, that's right. He did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy chick.
Fortune? Why don't you just run along, like he says? I'll meet up with you later. I'll call you if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Mr. Mushnick. Good night, Seymour.
Little red ducks all over the floor!
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
And a very strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of his motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnick Skibbroke's wife back in his office!
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I said to myself. I began to realize certain things I've noticed right here. Like little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it's stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it?
What are you talking about, Dad? Where are you going?
Especially whenever we remove our garbage once a month.
What has that got to do with?
Well, they get rid of something in a hurry. I'm not going to spill off the skid row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
Catching number now.
Sorry, last week. I didn't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot isn't innocent enough.
You've got no place to hide.
When I catch you, just the dentist's girlfriend.
You've got nowhere to run.
It seems to me like a motive.
He knows your life won't crawl.
But he's done. You move in, right?
I'm thinking suffering.
Yeah. I'm going to explain this.
Get your face off that.
Your old baseball cap. It's a man who comes to the clothes office. Show it to me and ask if I can identify it.
Did you?
No, don't suspect you at all. And then don't know that you're the new one. But then the doctor, the girlfriend, they didn't do it.
Sweetheart, doll face, bubble.
forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers and means for killing. New success would come with nasty, nasty trees. I sign these contracts, that means I'm living. I'm doing bloody awful evil things. No! Check us, we're back here. Right. You know, I don't think he's going to be with us for quite some time, Audrey. Audrey, can I ask you something? Let's just suppose for a minute that there had never been an Audrey too. And that I was just have nobody again and nothing. Would you still like me?
Oh, I still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled. Bullets, and the rat poison, and the machete, you know, bites the dust. Right after Life magazine takes the picture, we'll be famous, I'll take that TV job, and we'll run away from here, and no plan. when we get there, we'll live happily ever after. We'll have a nice little house and a nice car. No one will ever bother us again. And no night beatings. No more squealing for blood.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow, Audrey. Come on now.
No, I can't leave you in this room.
You don't have anything to be scared of. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Let's go home now, Audrey.
Feed me.
Under no circumstances.
Feed me.
I will not. So stop asking.
Feed me.
Look, how's about I run around the corner and get you some nice, juicy, rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till Life magazine gets here.
No way.
That's my last and final offer. Yes. Or no.
It's better than nothing.
Fine, wait, and don't think you get dessert.
Thank you.
Very simple license and deal. We take leaf cuttings, develop little audio tubes, and sell them to florists across the nation. I've got a truck waiting outside with some parts, so if you don't mind, we'll start taking leaf cuttings right away. Imagine, boy, audio tubes everywhere. But with the right advertising, this is going to be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger.
Every household in America, thousands of people, eating. That's what you've had planned all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
We're not just talking about one hungry plant people. We're talking about world conquest.
And I want to thank you.
You're a monster. And so am I.
Feed me.
You took away the only thing I ever loved.
Too bad,
yeah.
Open up! Open up! Open up!